Hello everyone, this is Cesar, and today I'm gonna teach you how to master the bar chords. So, first things first. This is a very early beginner's video. It has been requested for several of my viewers. I have other, I think, three videos about bar chords and exercises in my channel. I will put the link in the description section, but I'm trying to put together a lot of tips in this one, right? So you can watch the other ones that I'm gonna link, but this is going to be the video that is gonna help you mastering the bar chords. There are many misconceptions about learning bar chords and a lot of bad advice in YouTube. What I'm gonna share with you is what has been taught to me at the Conservatory of Music, and some of the things that have been working for me, right? And always from my perspective. I don't intend to be the guy who knows everything about everything, because I'm far from that. So let's get started with the first tip, which is going to be a bit controversial. If you have a classical guitar at home, like this one, or similar to this one, start practicing your bar chords, learning your bar chords, in a classical guitar. And why? Well, first of all, let me tell you, if you don't have a classical guitar at home, there's no problem. Everything we are going to discuss here can be practiced in an electric or an acoustic guitar. But why am I recommending, and we are recommending, not only me, starting in a classical guitar? For several reasons, but to me, the two main ones are these two. First, the fretboard radius. Fretboard radius is flat. I mean, it is flat. It does not have any curvature to it, right? So your finger, your index finger, is gonna be forced to really be straight. Straight, okay? And this is gonna be hard at the beginning. Though the strings are softer, having the finger, the index finger, totally parallel to the fretboard, because if not, the strings are not gonna sound okay, right? It's gonna force you to really have the right position and getting the strength in your hand to bar correctly the chords, right? To correctly bar the chords. Now, I know that you can say, why? So you are asking us to start with something that is harder. Yes, in the moment that then you will transition to an electric or to an acoustic guitar, even though the strings are a little bit tougher, but the curvature to the fretboard is gonna feel natural to your finger, you're gonna bar very well. You're gonna be much better positioned to bar the chords. So the first advice is this one. Also, the fretboard is wider, much wider than in an electric or an acoustic guitar, so it will force you to really execute the bar correctly, okay? Hence, the classical guitar, because of the wider fretboard and the flat radius, is going to help you exercising and getting the right position with your index finger. The second tip, I'm gonna do something very artificial with my hand, but it's for you to see what I'm meaning. Try always to bar the chord with your index finger as closer to the fret as possible. You are gonna get the best sound with the less effort. It's physics. In general, a good fretting technique is trying to fret the note always as close to the fret as possible, okay? Half a bar. Okay, so then barring as close to the fret as possible. Next tip, the position of the index finger. The index finger should be perfectly parallel to the fretboard. Again, I'm gonna do something very artificial with my hand, but just for you to see the visuals, right? Don't arc the finger, right? Don't get this position like a claw. I see a lot of students forcing themselves. This is gonna hurt, by the way, right? So, perfectly parallel to the fretboard. And if you watch carefully, you will see that there is a portion of my index that is showing on top of the fretboard, more or less that one, right? The tip of my index is showing on top of the fretboard, and that is the right way of barring the chords. Again, don't do the claw, don't arc your finger perfectly parallel. If you do the claw, it's gonna hurt you. I see a lot of guitar players in YouTube doing really very weird things with their fingers, right? It's gonna hurt, it's gonna contribute to give you a very nice wrist pain and probably a very nice tennis elbow, right? And that hurts, believe me. So, perfectly parallel to the fretboard and the tip of your finger showing up, right? And this is gonna help you to bar chords perfectly. Next tip. Your thumbs up, especially dedicated to the haters, right? This is something that a lot of people don't explain, in my opinion, correctly, right? But this is my opinion, of course. The bar chords are going to be an equilibrium of forces between the thumb and the index. The thumb is gonna push the fretboard, the neck, the entire neck of the guitar, forward. And the index is the one that is gonna try to take it backwards, right? And now let me show you how the thumb must be positioned. So this is the right position for your thumb. Okay? The thumb is going to do a grip with your index finger, but it's always going to be a little bit behind your index. Behind meaning on the left, right? And always a little bit skewed toward the headstock. Not like this, not perfectly parallel to the fretboard, but a little bit skewed toward the headstock. So remember, your thumb is gonna push your neck forward, your index is gonna bring your neck backwards towards yourself, right? And your thumb is going to be always a little bit skewed toward the headstock, a little bit with this lever, okay? And a bit behind your index. I hope it's clear, right? And this is going to help you really, ergonomically speaking, to fret the bar chords correctly. Well, now that you know a lot about the technique, let's go and do some exercises. Those exercises are some of the exercises I've learned at the Royal Academy of Music many years ago, right? And they helped me to develop the strength and the agility in my left hand in order to fret the bar chords correctly. So let's start with the first exercise. This is a very simple one. So what you're gonna do is that you're gonna take your index finger and you're gonna bar the first two strings. The thumb is gonna do exactly as we said before, okay? But only for the first two strings. Thumb is going to be a little bit behind the index and a little bit skewed toward the headstock, pushing your neck forward and your index pushing the neck towards you. And then you are gonna do this across different frets. Until they sound correctly. Now you're gonna repeat the same exercise but fretting three strings at the same time. Then you're gonna do the same, fretting four strings at the same time. Then you are going to do the same fretting five strings at the same time. And then you are going to do the same fretting the six strings. And you have to make all the strings sound correctly. If they sound like this, it's not okay. It's not okay. All the strings correctly. Remember, fretting closer to the fret. I'm gonna do something very, again, artificial with my hand. And all the strings should sound. Okay? There are people who help themselves with the middle finger, right? Putting the finger on top of the index in order to get more strength. I don't advise you to do that, though I sometimes do it, right? But it's because of the practice, right? Forget about that and let's focus on the basics of the technique, okay? Until all the strings sound correctly. That would be the first exercise. Next exercise. I'm going to ask you to consider your index finger as a capo. And I'm going to ask you to put the capo at the third fret. That's what you're going to do. Then, please fret an E major. And all the strings must sound correctly. Okay, all of them. First and sixth included. Okay. Now I'm going to ask you to fret an A minor. We'll do like that. And then I'm going to ask you please to fret a C major. Then what you're going to do is going through these three chords. And all the strings must sound correctly, including the first and the sixth string. So again, okay? And you are going to do that until all the strings sound correctly, again, including the first and the sixth. This is a great exercise to develop the strength. Don't forget to make the sixth string sound. Doesn't belong to this chord, I understand, but forget about it. We are practicing bar chords. The next tip is when you're practicing bar chords, try to not to fret open chords if you can fret bar chords. Let me tell you what I mean. If you are playing a G major, play it like this. If you're playing a C major, play it like this. Okay? And if you're playing a song that goes, play it like this. Barring all the chords. The idea is when you practice, try to substitute all the open chords that you can for bar chords. And then that will help you to develop the strength and the skill also in the changes. And my last tip is trying to get for yourself one of these finger exercisers, right? The spider finger exerciser. And if you don't have one, you can use a normal rubber band. I have the exercise of the rubber band in my channel that goes beyond the 1 million views. I took that exercise from a great guitar player in Spain, Gabriel Rosales, one of the best Spanish session guitar players ever, and he took it on his side from the great René Thomas, one of the biggest jazz guitar players of the history in France, right? Well, anyway, you get yourself the rubber band or the finger exerciser, and what this is gonna do is gonna add a little bit more of struggle in order for you to fret your bar chords. But then, you practice, you are going to develop a lot of strength, and this is going to help you to fly with your bar chords when you pick up your electric or acoustic guitar. Well, I hope you have enjoyed the video. Believe me, this is going to help you to master your bar chords. It's not going to happen from one day to another. Practice, practice, practice. And suddenly, one day, you will pick up your guitar, and this happens really suddenly after a lot of practice and a lot of frustration. It happens that suddenly one day it sounds, and it sounds beautiful, and you feel agile, and you feel good with your bar chords. Everybody has struggled with the bar chords. Don't listen, please, to the wrong advices, to these people that are telling you just to fret one, the sixth string and the first string because the others are already fretted. Don't listen to that advice. Practice the right way. This is the right way to master your bar chords. There are many, many different exercises, right? But with these techniques that I have explained to you, I think you are going to be able to master your bar chords if you practice. See you very soon in my next videos, and up to that moment, play your guitars, have fun, and be good. Bye.